Everybody, this is Praxis, and I'm finally not working in the downstairs bathroom today. I'm working in the upstairs bathroom. I finished up the vent pass-through using this hole saw just downstairs. The plan is to have both of the bathroom vents go out through the wall, then go down, kind of meet each other. They're not going to join because, you know, then if you run one, it could blow back up into the other one. But they're going to go parallel down, and I'm going to put them into like a gravel chamber or something like that where they're going to vent out their humidity and their heat and stuff underground down in the greenhouse. If we just vent it out into the air, the heat would just kind of blow away in the winter, and the humidity is kind of useful to, like, you know, keep the ground moist and everything. So that's the plan. We got one here, we got one below, and I'm making them so they're going to come down right next to each other. I'm just about to cut this hole here, but what I wanted to talk about is something, it's a technique I actually just learned. I've been practicing it. My dad answered a question I had, because I had this little piece of scrap from the pasture down there, and if you know, you're familiar with these sorts of pieces of air conduit. It's got like one, I guess this would be the female side and one male side, that has these little pleats in it, and one goes inside of the other. And I have this piece which had just, you know, was cut, so it didn't have the male side on it. And I was asking my dad if he had a tool for creating the male side, which is all those little pleats, and he said, you can actually use a pair of needle nose pliers. Now, I'm sure there is like a special tool you can kind of go around, it's like making pasta, you know, pleating the edges, but if you take a pair of needle nose pliers, and I took the liberty of practicing a bit before I demoed this for you, put them on there, do a little twist, and then go over, and another twist, and you see, it kind of like deforms it a little bit, but then you kind of pull it right back out like that. You're getting that kind of pleating edge, and it doesn't really have to look beautiful. The point of this is when you put the pleats in, it shrinks it down and it allows it to slide into, I don't know, can it even already make it? Yeah, I can pretty much already make it into this side here. Yeah, so I'm kind of done with that one already, actually, just pleating half the side. I guess I could have made smaller pleats. I'm going to go in and make it so that they don't kick in as much, because the more that you can have these kind of spread out, the less you're restricting the airflow. So I'm going to kind of dress these out a little bit, experiment with it. But as you can see, you can take something with two female ends, and you can turn one of them into a male end, and it can go in over there. So I'm going to get this thing ready to go through up here, and then I'm going to be doing spray foam to seal them on their way through. And also what I'm additionally going to do is, once they come on the inside, I am going to insulate the entire thing. And the reason for that, and I just have from experience seen that, you know, when it's cold outside, you get some like some cold air coming in or cooling the outside, and then you can get drips and condensation on, you know, because it'll get cool air in here, and then you have, you know, drips happening. So the entire thing, I'm either going to spray foam or put something around it to protect you know, the inside of the house from getting those condensation drips and everything. But that's what's going on right now. It's still just more wiring, getting these guys in, and like I said at the end of every video lately, step by step, we're getting there a little bit at a time. That's it. Thanks for watching.